Hi, so here's kind of the problem. This is a normal, really good college workout. Notice how much people are doing leg curls and then leg extensions instead of kicking as much from the core. They're pulling up off the knee joint to get in position to do a good dolphin kick. Now watch this guy. Dolphin is all up. The only time he bends his knees is after he flexes the muscles in the hip joint on the way up, and then he presses up. He's not bending his knees on the down, he's pressing it on the up. Here's what's called a reverse hyperextension. And this is at our gym in Corona, California, that's all specific to swimming. And these are just average kids, and that's me, an average coach. And we're doing straight leg reverse hyperextensions, which are much better for your hips. It really works the glutes, and it really reinforces what you're supposed to be doing on the up kick, or if you're on your back, your down kick, the setup part of the kick, so you don't stall out. So this takes some muscles that we don't normally work on, and this is called a reverse hyperextension machine. So this is one way to get strong enough, and it's a really outstanding way. We're not using weights yet on this, but we can. We've actually set it up for Olympic weights, and we have a few of these available at competitiveswimmer.com. Now this is another way. This is, we're using rings here, and we're using a stick on the back called a core kicker, and we're locking up the knee joint, so we have to kick from the core. And you're going to see a little bit more of this than I probably even want to show, but this is a video we did coach's eye. And you can see we're measuring we actually didn't lock him up fully here. So you can see 143 degree bend. He's actually in the down phase here of the kick. And we'll lock him up a little bit more as we go on, but I just kind of wanted to see you to see where the angles are in a great dolphin kick. And that the force phase of the kick being down with flexible ankles, you can see that dot we just put at the ankle there, flexible ankles makes it possible. Without flexible ankles, I don't care how strong your quads are, you're not going to beat a 9-year-old girl with flexible ankles. So, that's just key. So we do this thing called a Fankle, and we measure the ankle joint flexibility on a every other day basis, basically, and then we work on the ankles. So this guy has fairly good ankles he's like a 21 flat freestyle, maybe 20 point high. And you can see he's kicking here. He's not able to use his knee joint very much at all. So he's really got a fire there at the glutes, which you just saw in the reverse hyperextensions, and what you saw Lochte do. And then on the up kick, he's got a fire at the glutes to get it up. And then what we're not perfectly thrilled with is that he can't really bend his knee on this particular drill, but it really focuses him on having good flexible ankles and kicking from the core. So it's a great practice drill and a very good way to work your swimmers out. Same thing on, obviously, if you turn him over, get the same thing, see how aligned he is. He is able here to bend a little bit on the up kick, but it's really sort of annoying for him. Let me just put it that way. Sometimes he said it could actually hurt if he really tried to bend the knee. And that's great, because then he doesn't anymore and he kicks from the core. And then we take him off, he just flies, because he's used to not using the knee, used to using the abs and building that core, both on the front and the back. Normally when we talk about core, we don't do a whole lot for the lower back. It's a huge part of being able to kick well. You can see this angle here, and you can see the points that are important, and you can see that he is actually, we don't have him locked up as much as we can. Those are using rings in the core kick. You can actually get this as a set from competitiveswimmer.com. So you get this set, and then there's also a band that goes in between the two rings, or you can get that by itself, that actually controls the amount of whip kick, amount of distance between the knees and the whip kick. So this is called the rings. My last name is Frieda Rang, and we didn't really want anybody to knock us off on this. So it's called the Rang's Kit. But you can see the angles here, and we're really trying to fix that problem you saw at the beginning of the last video. So now you can see he's going with a full stroke. We really like that up kick here. And we go show that again. See how that up kick was nice and straight. And now he's firing at the hips. And his elbows dropped a little bit there, you can see, which we need to fix with other things. And he's a pretty strong swimmer, you know, probably a 48 or so, 40, maybe a 47 butterflyer. Here's a vertical kick drill with the same thing. and he has improved a lot. Look at that ankle flexibility. Really not too bad. And he's really putting some pressure on the water. This is certainly not Phelps or Lochte or Natalie Collin, etc., but he's good. He's got a good ankle flexibility, so he's able to do this drill without drowning and actually getting stronger. But we think this is going to drop. In fact, I think this season that we're filming this, he did drop significantly in the 50 and the 100 free. And we think this sort of things really, really help. So here's, again, dolphin kick. You can see the snapping there on the back. So he's getting reinforced to use his core. He'd probably be a little more flexible in the lower back and more flexible in the ankles. But now he knows he needs to do that. And he's really very good at it. Once he feels this, he knows what he needs to do. So we recommend the reverse hyperextensions. And in the water, we recommend the core kick stick in the back. And you can get those at competitiveswimmer.com. And these kinds of drills really help. Now, what doesn't help is putting fins on him. It's just going to be that much worse. He's going to be more likely to bend his knees on the down. Now, watch Lochte very carefully. The down kick is straight. The up kick only begins to bend the knees once he fires at the hips. You have to look at that very carefully. If you go frame by frame, you'll notice he's got it perfect. Thanks for watching. Check us out at competitiveswimmer.com. And swimpractice.org, where we have a lot of these videos to show you exactly what we're trying to accomplish. Never leave a wall without a goal. Talk to you soon.